Hey, what is up? It's Mikey, and we have an update to Infinite Warfare, and this may be one of the best updates yet. They added a lot of cool stuff. Let's just get into it. So first thing, main menu, they have added contracts. Very cool. You see here, we have 6 days to complete this, and let's go ahead and click on that. And first up is the JTF Wolverines. So we have team contracts now. You complete that contract and you get a reward of 15,000 XP. Very cool. And all you got to do is land 30 hits with lethals or tacticals. So yeah, expect the spam of tacticals to go up. I'm kind of hoping they randomize this, because otherwise every single match is going to be people spamming out EMPs and things like that. But the big one is the joint ops contract. Earn 125 kills with the SMG. Well, at least in my case. And I'll get an epic weapon hack. That seems really low, really easy. So I'm thinking this may be a glitch. For some people, they disappeared. So it's a little buggy right now. But the thing is, they're adding this. It'll take 6 days. So I'm thinking it's going to be quite a big contract. But once you get that epic weapon hack, you know, you may want to hold on to it, guys. Because whenever they give us cool things like this in the past, a couple of days later, a week later, the new weapon drops, and you know that the new DLC is coming soon. Yeah, you may want to hold on to it. Just saying, if you don't have any weapons, hey, go ahead and use it. But why not hold on to it? Hold on to it till at least the DLC drops and see what cool new weapons they add. And how it looks like in game, you can just hit the pause menu or the start menu, I mean, and there it is. You can see your progress on the bottom left. Also added is consumables, and here's what one of them looks like: a double XP token. You can use a double XP token to double the XP of your previous match. That sounds really good. Like in games like Destiny, you would pop something first and then hope you do really good. In this case, it's actually better. You can wait until you have a really good match and then pop that token. That sounds a little too good to be true, but there you go. Two very cool things they've added to Infinite Warfare. So the update was pretty big. It was at least a gig. So let's get into the general fixes, stuff that you guys are probably going to notice the most. I will have a link down below to the complete patch notes. First up, a fix for kills made with an energy weapon and a fusion mag were not tracking for the extended mag prestige challenge. They fixed that. You can now have fusion mag on your energy weapon and it will count with the extended mags challenge. Next up, the carpet bomb challenge. That thing was pretty broken. You had to get a triple kill with an airstrike, okay? It only counted with scorchers. So now it may be obtained using Trinity rockets, Bombardment, Warden, Thor, and Apex. They also did various map fixes, basically little exploits people were doing, getting into parts of the map you're not supposed to. And they made adjustments to the active camo visibility. It is now slightly more visible when you're in motion, and I have definitely noticed this in game. It only happened to me once, not too many people using it, I guess, while I was playing. But yes, you can definitely see the change. Now, the Shockwave update. Remember Derp Smash? Ruins Derp Smash used to do? Well, that's back. And here's some gameplay here. This credit goes to D'Lo Zerg. And what they've done is three things. They have increased the non-lethal damage, slightly increased non-lethal radius of shockwaves performed from low and moderate heights, slightly increased lethal radius of the shockwaves performed from moderate heights, and greatly increased lethal radius of shockwaves performed from great heights. And that's the gameplay we see here from Zerg. And yeah, it's just like the old school Derp Smash. Definitely gonna use that once I unlock it, because I just prestiged. They've also made adjustments to the slide, slightly reduced maximum initial slide velocity. And for Search and Destroy, for the map retaliation, defender spawns were moved forward to facilitate faster times to the bomb sites. So this is a very cool update, probably one of the most fun ones yet. Again, I will recommend holding on to that epic weapon hack at least until the DLC drops, but that's just me. Please take 3 seconds to rate the video. And for the open lobbies and stuff, I have been streaming every weekend on Twitch. So just follow me on Twitch, Twitter, Facebook, links down below if you want to get updates to come hang out, chat, or play with us. So on the top side there, we have my latest video in case you missed it. And on the bottom, we have the top clips of the week, the kill chains, trick shots, epic moments, search and destroy, all kinds of stuff. You can click on the screen or links down below.